In this video, we'll see how to implement an emulated frame buffer on the STM32H7S7 Discovery board. We'll also see the specificities of this board and general consideration for the emulated frame buffer. Hello and welcome to this How to Tell GFX video. My name is Gaetan, and previously we saw the different strategies. We saw that the emulated frame buffer strategy had various advantages, such as saving a lot of memory. So today we'll start from a project that has a double frame buffer and we'll turn that into a project with emulated frame buffer. Here is the result that we will achieve, a 800 by 480 pixel screen, but with a frame buffer that is only 1/4 of the size. First, we'll see how to enable the GFX MMU that is required for emulated frame buffer strategies. Then we will change from double frame buffer to emulated frame buffer. After that, we'll put the frame buffer inside the internal memory and see the different specificities of the H7S7. And finally, we will see general recommendation for the emulated frame buffer strategy. Let's start by creating a project in TouchGFX Designer. We will select the H7S7 Discovery Kit. Once we created the project, we can open the folder and open the IOC file. The first step is to enable the GFX MMU. It is located in Multimedia, but I can also search for it. We need to enable it for the application only. Here you can see the block size. You have the choice between 12 and 16. It is recommended to keep it at 16, unless you use RGB888. In that case, the pixel format is 3 bytes, which is 24 bits. So this is equivalent to 2 blocks of 12 bits. But the other formats are in 2 or 4 bytes, so the 16-bit block size is the best. We also need to enable the address translation. This way, we can move the partial frame buffer to actually emulate a full frame buffer. And that's all we have to enable in the GFX MMU. Now let's see how to modify the TouchGFX configuration. Now let's navigate to the TouchGFX configuration. Here, all we have to do is to change the frame buffer strategy. So from double to partial in that case. Now we could generate, but we could also change the number of blocks. If you do that, you have to make sure that the frame buffer height can be divided by the number of partial blocks. If we keep 4 partial blocks, it means that we will divide the frame buffer in 4. So we'll actually have only one frame buffer that is 1/4 of the height. So in that case, 120 pixels in height, but still 800 in width. We could also choose only 2 partial blocks, but in that case, we'd only save half the memory compared to a single frame buffer. On the other hand, if we choose 8 partial blocks, sure, we'll save a lot of memory, but the performance would be hit a bit. So the partial frame buffer size is a trade-off between memory and performance. 4 partial blocks is usually a good starting point. Now let's generate code and go back to TouchGFX Designer. Here we can try to flash the board, but we'll see that we'll have an error. It's because we did not include the GFX MMU. This is specific to the makefile, so we'll have to modify it. Let's jump to VS Code and open GCC, then the makefile appli that is specific to the application, because only the application is using the GFX MMU. Now we can copy a driver's path and modify it to GFX MMU. Let's save and flash again. This time it compiles and flash, but if we really want to take advantage of the emulated frame buffer, let's try to move it from the external to the internal memory. To be able to place our emulated frame buffer in the internal memory, we'll have to save some flash. To do so, we'll change the vector rendering from hardware to software. That is because the vector rendering in hardware requires more code to access the hardware. Let's generate CubeMX code again and go back to VS Code. This time, we'll open the linker script. We will look for the buffer section that contains two things, the frame buffer and the stencil. We can rename that section to frame buffer section. We do not want the stencil anymore, and put it in RAM this time. Back to TouchGFX Designer, we'll flash the board again. However, we get an error. we have an overflow in memory. That is because in the H7S7, we enable the animation buffer. In a previous video, we saw that it is used to enable a transition. So let's go back to VS Code and let's remove it. This buffer is located into Apply, TouchGFX, Target, and TouchGFX Hall. Here it is. So let's remove that memory allocation. And we also need to remove one more line, the one that states the animation storage. Finally, we can go back to TouchGFX Designer one more time and flash the board. This time it compiles correctly. I'll create a quick GUI to check that everything works correctly. Okay, I've made a simple GUI. We have two buttons that will move the box. Let's flash this GUI into my STM32H7S7. Everything looks fine. The button gets triggered, the box moves correctly. There's no tearing or artifact, even though we use only a quarter of the standard frame buffer size, which allows us to put it in the internal RAM. We also recommend to not use elements that are too big and that will span over the partial frame buffer. Furthermore, once you have a working TBS, you can set the data cache. But make sure that the memory protection unit is correctly set. You have to make sure that the partial frame data is updated when necessary. In this video, we saw how easy it is to implement an emulated frame buffer strategy that allows you to save a lot of memory. Remember that this strategy can only be used with MCU that embeds the GFX MMU. Also, it is not recommended with SVG, large assets, or elements that are computation heavy for this strategy. That is because on the normal strategies, the rendering has to be done in less than 16 milliseconds. But with a partial frame buffer that is 1/4 of the screen size, then the rendering has to be done in less than 4 milliseconds. If you want to keep learning, you can check our documentation, our API, and our tutorial on our website. Please find the link in the description. Also, you can check our other video in this playlist where we talk about various subjects. Finally, if you have a specific question, you can ask it on the ST forum. Thank you for your attention and see you in the next one.